desert flatlands outside Tucson, Arizona, the site of a second-generation missile, Titan II. This is the first time Titan II has been filmed. It is the most powerful of the nation's ICBMs. It carries several megatons of nuclear destruction packed behind this metal shell, a cataclysm reserved for the most deeply buried enemy targets. In modified form, Titan II is expected to launch two-man astronaut teams on Gemini orbital flights. Titan II is simpler than Titan I, a diesel locomotive compared to an obsolete steam engine. Titan II does not have to be lifted to ground level. It blasts off from deep inside its silo. The underground support area is compact, nothing like that subway at Times Square. There is no ground guidance system. All guidance is aboard the missile. The missile requires no liquid oxygen with all of its headaches, refrigerated storage tanks, and 11th-hour fueling. Titan II uses newer fuels, hypergolic liquids, which burst into flame as soon as valves open and the liquids mix. Countdown time is not 15 minutes, but less than 1 minute. Shock mounting of the entire installation is standard here, too. Titan II would be a number one enemy objective. Life in the claustrophobic capsule is a far cry from the soaring cabin of an eight-jet bomber. But the responsibility is the same. Motivation of the combat crews is the same. Training is every bit as intense as anywhere else in SAC.
Attention crew, we have a valid launch order at this time. Would you acknowledge, please?
Roger, Deputy. MFD.
Deputy, at this time, you've verified that all personnel are clear of the silo area.
Roger, Commander. Verifying that all personnel are clear of silo area.
Roger. We have a launch enabled light at this time. Batteries activated, lighted.